Hi there.
Welcome back to my workshop. You know what? I really do enjoy archery. Archery is where you take the bow and you pull back the string, shoot the arrow towards the target that you're aiming at. Not only do I enjoy shooting my bows and arrows, I also enjoy creating them. An arrow needs to be as straight as possible to be accurate. If the arrow is bent, it will not fly straight. If it does not fly straight, it'll miss its mark. You know, one way I make an arrow is out of bamboo stakes. I buy a package of bamboo stakes at the hardware store. I choose the stakes that's the correct diameter and then cut them to the proper length. This is where the challenge begins. Anyone can cut a stick to the proper length, but the stake is not yet ready to be an arrow. First, the stake is crooked, and it needs to be straightened. Well, I take my heat gun and heat up the bamboo stake, rotating it so it'll not get too hot and catch on fire. And when I think the fibers in the bamboo are hot enough, then I apply pressure and straighten out the curve area. Then I peer down the arrow, the length of it, to find the next bend and do the same process all over again. Once all of the curves have been straightened, then I let it cool. Once it's cool, I roll on the table to check its straightness. Sometimes it takes me over 30 minutes to make the shaft as straight as possible, so it will roll evenly on the table. There are lots of times where I'd have to go back and re-straighten the shaft. Once I have the shaft, I think, is quite straight, I continue creating the arrow. I cut the nock, paint the end, and then coat the whole shaft with urethane. The arrow is still not finished until I establish the point and attach the feathers. The feathers are called fletchings, and they help the arrow spin as it flies through the air. The spinning helps to keep the arrow flying towards the target. If you have a warble or a bend in the arrow, you'll then have a wobble in your flight. Back to the bamboo shaft. Could you imagine if the bamboo stake decided to talk back to me? I pull it out of the package, and it begins to squirm and shout, "What are you doing? Being in this plastic bag is all I've ever known. Don't take me away from my friends. Put me back, please." As I lay the shaft on the table, ready to measure it, it rebels. "What have you done? Why did you put that horrid mark on me? That's permanent, you know. It won't come off." As I get my saw and cut it to length, the bamboo shaft screams in horror, "Those teeth on that saw are sharp! You can't be serious. Are you actually going to use that monster with really small teeth to hack off part of me? I'll sue if you come any closer with that saw." "Oh, great," the bamboo says. "Now I'm beside myself." "Hey, buddy, just glue the pieces back together, okay? And make me whole and in one piece again." As I use my heat gun to heat up the bend, the shaft complains, "Enough! Enough already! When you started with this torture device, the heat felt so good. But enough is enough. What? Are you trying to cook me? Give me a break." Once I make the entire shaft as straight as possible, the shaft protests, "I don't want to be controlled and manipulated. I like the way I was." "Seriously? You want me to be conformed to your wishes? What about what I want?" As I roll the arrow on the table to check for straightness, the shaft is about to hurl, because I'm so dizzy from being rolled back and forth. Whatever happened to my rights? When I'm satisfied that the shaft is straight, I let it cool. So I let it take its new shape. And again, the shaft objects. "You can't leave me alone on this table. What? Are you leaving me in the dark? What will become of me?" I know it's silly to think that a piece of bamboo could express its feelings like that, but how often are we like the bamboo? God, our master and designer, has great plans for our lives, but we complain, "No, I like hanging around with my friends. I'm comfortable here." We know that God will change us, but we don't want to have His mark of approval. We don't want to measure up to His standards, so we balk and we squirm. We know that there are things in our lives that are not pleasing to the Lord. Some of these habits are harmful to our bodies, yet we don't want to cut them out of our lives, even though we know getting rid of them will help us become more like Jesus. When the heat of God's holiness is applied to our character, do we resist being transformed by God? When we allow the heat and the pressure of our God and Master's hands, He will gently straighten us. Straighten out those areas of our lives that would cause us to wobble and move outside of the mark that God has intended for us. Just like the rolling of the arrow is a process to check its alignment and straightness, so should our relationship with Jesus be. Salvation, serving God, and loving Him is a process. The Bible assures us that we can be convinced that what God has started, He will work out till the day of completion. Then we'll be just what He wants us to be, perfect. Unlike the bamboo stake, we are alive. We do have feelings. We have a personality. We have a free will, and we can choose. God wants to be our master, and He knows His plans for each one of us. Jeremiah 29:11 says this, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you a hope and a future." Yet, even though He has a perfect plan, He will not force His will on us. We have to choose to let God have His way. We need to tell Him, "I'm putting my life in Your hands to mold and to make me into what You have planned for me." Only when we choose to allow God to perform His care, direction, and influence in our lives will we be able to fly straight and hit the mark. Hey, anytime you want to shoot some archery, hey, just give me a jingle. And if I'm free, well, we'll try to hit some bullseyes together.